They say, when you hear the sounds of devils, all else is quiet. My general question to that is, how do you know if what you are hearing is the work of such devious beings? I would venture to say that most devilish noises occur when large numbers of men decide to force the hand of mortality upon one another. And I'd say further that on such occasions, there is not just one sound, but many. It is a quiet orchestra of death. It's also possible that the man who wrote that saying might have just had some broke ears. I had been moved from one wiped out regiment to the next, witnessing countless mortal follies. I met General McLean in the last summer of the war. Peculiar man.
Captain Lee Briggs.
Sir.
Men of nine lives. You any idea how many divisions have us pinned here?
No, sir.
Let's just say, enough to make fate unfavorable. Now, I've got a job for you, Briggs. It has recently come to my attention that an object of the grandest design has been discovered east of the Colorado Basin. Given the undeniable truth that we here are on a collision course with destiny, neither I nor my men will be able to give witness to this object. Someone ought to see it. I reckon it should be you. Sole survivor of the 22nd Connecticut. Even one man alive is homage to the rest. Make record of your journey, Briggs.
To be given a pass, to watch all others go, is perhaps the most troubling thing to one's being. Sometimes when I wake up, I feel like I'm still sleeping. I feel like all the colors and shapes of the world have collided, and all I can do is just sit there and watch. I think a person's heart has a way of turning off when it can't find reason. I guess that's why nature has always had an inspiring presence. Everything follows a purpose. I guess we're missing something. Why do we struggle to breathe a more righteous breath when we all end up in the same place. I'd like to hope our history is worth remembering. An imprint of careful design, a feeling of heartfelt purpose, and a sense of hope for something bigger than ourselves. Then, maybe I'll wake up.
Doing fine. How are you?
We're all doing well. We've been monitoring your interlink bipeds. Very pleased with the results. How are you feeling now that you've been able to settle in?
Good. Station's in pretty decent shape. The only device it seems really out of whack is the RS-7 pump. It seems to be operating at half pressure.
No, don't worry. We'll add it to the squad sheet.
Well, for the sake of future ISS inhabitants, I strongly recommend it.
Do you receive the data package?
Yeah, it just started. Houston, this thing ain't opening. Do you want to resend it?
No, why don't you give the audio a try?
All right, one moment.
Captain Lee Miller!
Yeah, we recorded it the other night.
Oh, God.
We've been in space for almost 20 years now, right? I gotta say, I feel so honored and thankful.
Sound terrible.
To be one of the first to be going back after so long.
I'll make sure the guys get the visual for you.
I'm nervous.
We have a comm link test down here at 2300, so we'll be back in the morning.
All right, you guys have a good night.
Likewise. Houston and Cambridge up.
Copy that. This is ISS.
ISS, this is 23 Alpha.
Okay.
I'm gonna say 8 packets. We'll figure the constant.
8 packets is a hell of a projection.
Yeah. Well, they want to see if the ISS will stay in orbit without remote positioning.
Copy that. Did you receive them?
Looks like it. Thanks. How are you holding up?
Good.
Good. Well, don't want to keep you. 23 Alpha out. Godspeed, Lee.
Godspeed to you, too. Copy that. It's downloading right now. Did you guys re-zipper the clip from the late show?
Negative, negative. I believe the chat will get that to you later. This is a recorded message from your brother.
Copy that.
Cheers.
Hey, buddy. Hope everything's going well up there. Thinking about you. But the important news is you are officially an uncle. You've got a nephew, and he's beautiful. He's just incredible. But he can't wait to meet you. I'm gonna try to send some photos if I can figure out. It's so complicated to do that with these guys. Anyway, take care of yourself, please. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Hey, Houston, did you pick that up? Cambridge, have I been crossed over yet? Cambridge, this is ISS 37. Did you guys pick up that radio interference?
People need other people. That's why I really think I'm a storyteller. I'll get into situations where I probably maybe should stick my nose in, but I do. Because I feel that I've seen a lot. I've been through a lot. That's really, in my opinion, the only way to really communicate among the races and the people in the world. And if I can drop a word here or there, or a little tale here or there, that I think might help somebody, I'll drop it like a bomb. And if something like that ever did happen, where everybody stopped talking, everybody stopped telling stories, everybody stopped relating, nobody learns anything, no one does anything. I wouldn't even want to think what it'd be like. Maybe peaceful as hell. I think it'd be a horrible world.
I'm
MC, this is ISS. Do you guys have a read on me? MC, this is ISS. Do you copy?
This is genius. Make a big radio with English buttons and then write a manual for it in Russian.
Houston, this is ISS. Do you copy? Houston, Cambridge, do you copy? I don't know what kind of transmission that was, man. Unless I'm mistaken, we're nowhere near April. So I'm gonna need a confirmation of any sort of mission extension from you assholes. Look, I don't think it's funny, and if you guys are doing some type of stress experiments or isolation test, well, you can stop now because I'm very isolated and very stressed. If the line is open enough for me to get a pre-recorded message, then I know you can hear me, and I would appreciate knowing what the hell is going on! Houston? Cambridge, this is ISS. Do you copy? Thank you.
Activity is suddenly just cut, and you're just left kind of standing by yourself in the darkness, kind of like, I didn't see that coming. What was that all about? You know, like, where do I go from here? And I think we control our own surroundings for the, for the most part, we control our own surroundings. We can decide to go here or there, but once we've established ourselves, I think that's when our environment starts to take a toll on our personality and, you know, our habits and the way we think every day. We're social creatures and we need to interact with people. That's why relationships are so important, so just crucial for existence. If you don't talk to anybody, you don't interact with anybody, then your whole sense of reality is pretty warped.
Physical diagnostics check.
I
I should make a proper introduction since I am the captain. My name is Lee. And you are? You're an astronaut. Who's Polaroid I'm talking to? We would definitely have some problems. Gotta love your smile. How about this? I catch a bite off this joint. Get back home. Take a shower. Throw on a suit. We'll head downtown, East Village. Great little Italian restaurant.
But in hell, while I'm making it up, how about a nice Malibu sunset?
Oh, it's the best. Sunset.
Whose idea was it to try to make a shower?
Open a shower.
That's right. You've got a nephew, and he's... I'm gonna try to send some photos if I can figure out...
No 3 seconds on the shot clock. Ball's passed into play. Goes to Miller. He shoots!
Roll it.
hell is my video?
Station's broken.
I'm choosing to entertain you because A, my logic slipped a long time ago, and B,
I forgot what B was, but.
Reason in your head, and it's probably in mine too. Journal of Captain Lee Briggs, 22nd Connecticut, 7th Infantry Division. My personal thoughts and findings leading to our discovery. June 4th, 1864.
You know, if you can plan life, But yet, it doesn't mean it's gonna happen. You know, you can plan and plan and plan and put something over here and design something over here and put borders on this and that in life, but it doesn't mean anything. So you're not in control. Because nothing is guaranteed and nothing is secure in this world. So what is the most important thing? I mean, everybody wants to be loved, and you know, you don't really, and when you actually feel it, I mean, I think kind of like with your parents, it's kind of one of those things where it just is what it is because you grow up into it. But when you actually experience it with someone else outside of that shell, it's very interesting. It's very fulfilling.
Feet again at Chancellorville. It's quite an assembly
feeling to face one's nerves this often. To accept death before each called advance is frightening. Yet it is the only way to move boots made solid by the sounds of shelling. I can't explain all this. What uncertainty does to a man's soul. I do know it can drive the mind mad. $17,000 dead in one engagement. to Sir Loser.
Okay. This is the space station, right? We are approximately 220 miles from Earth, okay?
You see, the original space station was what they called LEO, which stands for Low Earth Orbit. Later, with some technology, we were able to go a lot farther than that. Assure me that it's not the shape, but what lies over the ridges and crest.
What? I'm looking at it from a different angle. Well, I don't like the ending either, but I'm not reading it with my eyes. I'm reading it through this monitor, so we can make sure that we have missed no details of our odd tale.
How can eyes that have seen so much be brought to life by a simple thing? It is as if we have some sort of predestined tempo of destruction. I've decided that I am not looking for one discovery. I'm simply hoping that we have a history worth remembering. An imprint,
of careful design, a feeling of heartfelt purpose, a sense of hope and well-being.
Here forever, because what will we do with all this time?
I know. Hey, is your mouth dry? Yeah, mine too. Am I scared? is Lee James Miller, son of Courtney and Michael Miller. I lost contact with Mission Control on July 7th, 2039. I have remained in a perennial orbit for 6 years. My mission has long since been terminated, and my daily routine has been based on stretching my life support systems. I've observed neither contact nor indication of any awareness of my current condition. It is with great sadness, but determined resolution, that I must finally abandon this post. Systems here can no longer be depended on, and I would rather face the journey home than the slow, breathless environment of failing O2. While I have no idea what the circumstances are surrounding my abandonment, I would rather rest on Earth than up here alone. I have come to terms with the fact that some things will forever remain a mystery. To whomever this message reaches, I leave in goodwill towards all. Respectfully, Captain Lee James Miller, July 7th, 2045.
When you get into a situation where absolutely nothing's in your control, it makes you wonder sometimes. And very often I've been in those circumstances where all of a sudden you're not calling the shots, you're basically along for the ride. Yeah, I mean, even on a simplistic note, I lost a wheel off a vehicle, off the van, a couple of years ago, taking my son to school in really pretty heavy traffic. And it could have been an absolute disaster, but all of a sudden I'm driving down the road and the passenger wheel overtakes us. And I mean, I was along for the ride. There's nothing I could do because I had no brakes, I had no steering. And it was just really fortunate that the van veered off to the shoulder, and it could have gone into the oncoming traffic and it could have been a whole disaster. And it's really rather surprising what flashes through your mind in those few split seconds while this stuff's going on. I mean, you think about all sorts of strange things. But for people to remember me, or any one particular thing, I think it would be for the fact that never give up. Just keep trying. Don't just accept it and say, well, yes, this is what it is. Strive for something better.
The space station itself has been empty for a long time, right? I mean, so when you get there, I mean, is there going to be housework to do? I mean, is there going to be, like, dishes in the sink you got to clean up after?
No, there's no house chores or dishes in space, thank God.
We haven't been in space in almost 20 years now, right? How do you feel about that?
Hey, I feel so honored to be one of the first to be going back after so long. A little nervous, but excited.
Now, I assume that the testing and the preparation has been quite extensive.
Sorry about this projection, but it's the only way we could reach you. I can't tell you how relieved we are to have you here. Now, before we get ahead of ourselves, we have to tell you something. You're the last one. It's all gone. We understand how you might feel. Connection is perhaps the most cherished thing any being can have. That's the thing. That's why we've been listening. The place you see here is a scrapbook of sorts, a collection of memories and mementos of mankind's brief existence.
You gotta remember the good things and cherish the memories and go on with life because it don't stop.
You only have to remember that what you've done in your life may change what someone else is doing in their life, and so therefore your life continues in their eyes.
It's a good thing we found you. We look forward to meeting you, Lee.
Thank you. worldwide has been a wonderful experiment of human contact. A symbiotic relationship between man and machine and you.